Sir, regarding the most talked issue, that is the Naga political issue. Naga political issue. The talks have been going on for last more than 20 years. What is your comment on that?
I have been telling leaders of India, if they have to resolve the Naga problem, it has to be now. Why? Number one, at least the political group of the underground, they also become more realistic. And we should appreciate your problem also. Now, in the past, they were talking only one agenda, that is sovereignty. But with the signing of the peace accord on 3rd August 2015, in the presence of Prime Minister and Home Minister, we can safely say that the issue of sovereignty is no longer there. And the only agenda of Naga people was sovereignty. Once that is removed, what is the problem for Government of India to resolve the Naga issue within the parameter of the Constitution of India? So when underground people could see the reality of the politics in the country and the world, I think this opportunity should not be allowed to frittered away by the Government of India. And therefore, I would express very strongly that this is the time that settlement must be made by the Government of India. And it requires, I think, political will to do so. We should also appreciate the sagacity of the underground people in realizing that something should be done, which is honorable both Government of India and Naga people. And I think the process which is being on for the last few years, it is in the right direction. So Government of India should also recognize the genuineness of the feeling of those underground people in their endeavor to come to a logical conclusion of the Naga politics.
Sir, do you think that the state government's role in these political talks is important at this stage?
Honestly, I want to make it very clear. This is the right time that the government of Nagaland should actively involve in certain issues. Number one, if final settlement is made, definitely decommissioning of weapons and rehabilitation of underground people will be there. So we have to work in detail to suitably accommodate those underground in that kind of scheme. And state has to play the major role, and therefore they should have started what kind of rehabilitation and a scheme would be more appropriate, suitable for underground. And instead of only facilitator, I think they should actively involve in concretizing the rehabilitation scheme. That's one. Secondly, since Nagaland state is the only mandated constitutionally by the people, I think they should directly involve in convincing Government of India to take the matter very seriously. And thirdly, they should also mobilize public opinion in the state that since sovereignty is not feasible now, I think people should appreciate the political realities of today in the country, in the world, and therefore, whatever is being done, initiated by this underground, I think if it can accommodate a large, I think this quantum of this autonomy, I think we should also recognize their effort. Instead of blaming, I think we should also realize their difficulties and reality of the situation. So these three roles, state government should play also. But they are not doing.
So what about the role of the NGOs? The Naga NGOs who have been trying to bring all the factions together on the board.
That was the right move. And now at least there will be only one settlement. Now they have negotiated with IM, now with six groups. So ultimately they are aiming at a single political settlement for Nagaland. And that will be a blessing for us also.